There's no feeling more discouraging than starting over. And that's what you're about to experience if you keep playing this game. It's going to be deeply frustrating. You might trade some of that frustration for disappointment if you are willing to admit that the mistake was yours and only yours, but the feeling will only get more intense the longer you play. You're going to want to keep playing, and every time you don't, every time you find the strength to keep going, you will only be setting yourself up for a bigger fall. And if you manage to get to the top, will that make you feel good? Will you feel that it's all been worth it? I think you will. Feel free to stop playing whenever you want. Your progress will be saved automatically. Your dose of progress too. This game is a different take on a game that came out in 2017 titled Getting Over It with Bennett Foddy. The author of that game, Bennett Foddy, was an Australian designer known at the time as the father of intentionally bad controls. Weird, unresponsive, and hard to understand, intentionally bad controls are bad in the sense that they are suboptimal for the task at hand, making a challenging and infuriating experience of what otherwise could well be a walk in the park. And yet, they often make for amusing games. In Getting Over It, your task is simply to climb up a mountain, to dragging yourself with a hammer while sitting inside a cauldron. No amount of forward progress is guaranteed, some cliffs are too sheer or too slippery, and the player is in constant danger of falling and losing everything. I watched a video of Bennett Foddy playing his own game, and it was interesting to see how erratically he approached his own challenges. He knew it was possible to overcome them, and he knew the movements he needed to execute. So he will make an attempt, but he will fail, without a clear reason why. So he will try again, exactly the same movements he attempted the first time. And he will repeat this process until, eventually, it actually worked, giving the impression that the challenge was more about perseverance and luck than precision. In Getting Over It, Bennett Foddy claims that frustration is essential to the act of climbing, but I disagree. Frustration might be essential to having a real challenge, an obstacle that you are not guaranteed to be able to overcome, but the act of climbing itself can be enjoyable. Climbing in Getting Over It is not frustrating because you can easily fall down and lose all your progress, but because controlling the main character is infuriating. Of course, falling and losing all your progress is also frustrating. But the worst part is not that you have to climb it all over again, it's that you have to fight with the controls while doing so. This game is pretty much like Getting Over It. You need to climb up a world made of pre-made assets, while the game creator talks to you about the game itself. And the point of the game is built around the fact that it's a very hard challenge and you can easily lose all your progress at any time. The main difference, what makes this game more than just a clone of the original, is its controls. Not only because hitting a ball is quite different from pulling yourself with a hammer, but because it's easy and intuitive to control. You hit the ball with a certain force at a certain angle, and that's it. The difficulty lies in calculating what force and what angle you should apply to the ball. And it's not infuriating because you feel in control. If the ball doesn't land where you wanted, you know it's because you did the wrong calculations, and you feel that you can do it better if you try again. This is a game in which you can experience the challenge of climbing an unyielding mountain without infuriating controls being part of that challenge. But that's not the reason why I made this game. It's only why I thought it was worth finishing. So, why did I make this game? I was lying in bed, thinking of an unusual concept for a golf game. It had nothing to do with this one, except for the fact that it will be challenging and potentially frustrating. I was considering if that frustration will be similar to that of Getting Over It. And then, a title just popped up in my mind. Golfing Over It, with Alva Majo. I generally hate having to repeat a part of a video game over and over until I can beat it. Avoiding that is probably the main point of my design philosophy. So why did I make this game? The truth is, it was an accident, like an unplanned pregnancy. After coming up with the title, I wanted to test the concept, just to see what it would feel like. I created the ball and the controls, then I started building and testing the world. And it was fun. It was so much fun. I got into a deep state of flow. I worked all day, forgetting to eat, not wanting to sleep. I did the same the day after, and the one after that. And before I knew it, the body of the game was finished. I would have never planned to make a game like this. Even if we forget my design principles for a moment, I would have never made a game that lives only as the shadow of another one. It feels cheap. It doesn't reflect well on me as an artist. And yet, I couldn't bring myself to stop there. To delete the game and move on. I felt like this game deserved to be made. In the end, I decided to embrace this fate. I will finish making this frustrating game, and I will make it all about its relationship to getting over it, like an unofficial spiritual sequel. We are close to the top now, you must have suffered a lot to get here. But I wonder, given the chance, will you choose to make things easier for yourself, or will you choose to suffer even more? The choice is yours, there's no reward for choosing one or the other, except for the rewarding feeling you might experience for overcoming, or avoiding, an extra bit of challenge. That must have hurt. Don't worry though, it will happen again. And again. And again. Hey, you're almost there! What you have done is pretty incredible. It's heroic. You are my hero, and I applaud you. Well done.